is life here on Earth. But what other places could there be life? This could be life that we might recognize, and maybe even life as we don't understand it. People always accuse me of being closed-minded towards the search for life. Why do I always want there to be an energy source and liquid water? Why am I so hydrocentric? Scientists understand how life works here on Earth. Wherever we find liquid water, we find life. Under glaciers, in your armpits, hydrothermal vents, in acidic water, up your nose, etc. Water acts as a solvent, a place where atoms can be moved around and built into new structures by life forms. So it makes sense to search for liquid water, as it always seems to have life there. So where could we go searching for liquid water in the rest of the universe? Under the surface of Europa, there are deep oceans. They're warmed by the gravitational interactions of Jupiter, tidally flexing the surface of the moon. And there could be life huddled around volcanic vents within its ocean. There's a similar situation in Saturn's moon Enceladus, which is spewing out water ice into space. There might be vast reserves of liquid water underneath its surface. You can imagine a habitable moon orbiting a gas giant in another star system. Or maybe you could just let George Lucas imagine it for you and fill it with Ewoks. Let's look further afield. What about dying white dwarf stars? Even though their main sequence days are over, they're still giving off a lot of energy, and they will still slowly cool down over the coming billions of years. Brown dwarfs could get in on the action too. Even though they've never had enough mass to ignite solar fusion, they're still generating heat, and this could provide a safe, warm place for planets to harbor life. It gets a little trickier in either of these systems. White and brown dwarfs would have very narrow habitable zones, maybe 1/100th the size of the one in our solar system. And it might shift too quickly for life to get started or survive for very long. And this is our view, what we know life to be with water as a solvent. But astrobiologists have found other liquids that might work as solvents too. What about life forms that live in oceans of liquid methane on Titan? Or creatures that use silicon or boron instead of carbon? It might just not be science fiction after all. It's a vast universe out there, stranger than we can imagine. And astronomers are looking for life wherever it makes sense, wherever there's liquid water. And if they don't find any there, they'll start looking for places that don't make sense. So what do you think? When we first find life, what will be its core building block? Silicon, boron, or something even more exotic? Thanks for watching. Never miss an episode by clicking subscribe. We couldn't do this without the members of our Patreon community. People like David Seaston and the many others who help us create and deliver great space and astronomy content. If you'd like to join our community, which gets you advanced access to episodes as well as extras and behind the scenes content, click here and head on over to Patreon. Man, are we advertising Patreon? Patreon.